Electronics recycling is rarely done the way you or I would expect. Discarded computers are often shipped to developing countries where they mine them for raw materials. There are hundreds of scrapyards just like this one, all over the world. I shot the footage you just saw, and I've seen firsthand the devastation caused by our throwaway culture. The lifespan of electronics is getting shorter and shorter, causing incredible growth in e-waste shipments to the developing world. Electronic waste is actually toxic. Computer boards have arsenic, mercury, lead, and environmentally devastating polybrominated flame retardants. The people I met who burn these computers to extract the copper don't know they are breathing in these toxic chemicals. They're burning our waste, and it's our responsibility. We need to come together and find a solution to this toxic problem. We can't continue to manufacture hundreds of millions of electronic devices every year, rapidly consuming them and then tossing them away. Fortunately, this is a solvable problem. We can dramatically reduce the number of devices that end up in landfills by just making them work longer. We must make it possible, even easy, for people to fix their own electronics. If we could double the useful life of the devices we consume, we could cut the amount of e-waste in half. Imagine if everyone in the world had free access to repair information. How many more things would people fix? How long could we make things last? We are writing a free, step-by-step repair manual for every device. This is a monumental, Wikipedia-scale task. We are manufacturing new kinds of devices at an unprecedented pace. And if we don't act now, we will lose the opportunity to fix these devices while they still have economic value. But like many big, hard problems, this is also something that we must do, something that we can do. We need help from people all over the world. I need your help to show people how to fix everything. iFixit has already empowered hundreds of thousands of people to fix things themselves. Try it out yourself. Take something apart that doesn't work, understand the problem enough that you can fix it, and then put it back together. It is the greatest feeling in the world when it turns on and you know that you fixed it. It's so exciting to know that you can have control of your own hardware, that you can fix it if something happens, and that you can be self-reliant and reduce your environmental footprint. We need your help to make things last longer. I don't know how to fix everything, but I know how to fix some things, and I'm eager to share what I know. I can imagine a world where people have free access to a repair manual for everything. I can imagine a time when people fix things when they break, and where parents teach their children to value the things that they own. I can imagine a culture built around the joy of making and repairing things, rather than just using things up and tossing them away. I can imagine people starting small repair businesses all over the world using freely available service manuals. I can imagine a future where technology is a sustainable part of our lives, empowering us all to work together to make the world a better place.